When we look around today, LEDs are everywhere, in our phone screens, our car headlights, the lamps in our rooms, even on the screen you're watching right now. But until the 1990s, one color was missing, blue. Red existed, green existed, but blue didn't. And without blue, there was no white light, which meant lighting up cities, homes, and the world with LEDs was impossible. But why? Why was creating blue light so difficult? This is the story of a mystery that puzzled scientists for decades, and of one engineer who refused to believe in the word impossible. An LED, short for light-emitting diode, is a tiny semiconductor that turns electricity into light. When electrons jump from a higher energy level to a lower one, they release that energy as light. This energy difference is called the band gap, and the size of that gap determines the color of the light. A small gap gives red light, a larger gap gives blue light. So, to create blue, you need a material with a very large energy gap. But that's where things get complicated. In the 1960s, red and green LEDs already existed because suitable materials for those colors were known, gallium arsenide, gallium phosphide. But for blue, nothing worked. Blue light requires much higher energy, and the materials capable of producing it were brittle, fragile, and full of crystal defects. Those defects made electrons lose energy as heat instead of light, so the LED would glow weakly, and then overheat. Decades of experiments, thousands of failures. Occasionally, a faint blue glow, that's but far too weak to be useful. By the late 1980s, everyone said the same thing. A blue LED is impossible. In theory, there was one promising material, gallium nitride, or GaN. It had exactly the right energy gap for blue light, but there were two major problems. First, crystal quality. GaN crystals were full of defects. Second, P-type doping didn't work. Scientists couldn't make it conduct positive charge. Big companies gave up on it. They called it a waste of time. But in Japan, a small company called Nichia kept trying. And there, an engineer refused to quit. His name was Shuji Nakamura. Nakamura wasn't working in a huge lab, just a small workshop, but he had something bigger than funding, persistence. He grew GaN crystals in new ways, changed gas flows, adjusted temperatures, even redesigned the reactor itself. Then, to overcome the biggest obstacle, he tried a radical idea, heating the crystal again. During that process, hydrogen escaped from the surface, and suddenly the P-type regions became active. The result, for the first time ever, a bright, pure blue light. The year was 1992, and the blue LED was finally real. The blue LED wasn't just another color. It was the key to white light. Combine red, green, and blue, and you get white. Or coat a blue LED with yellow phosphor, and you create cool white light. Every LED lamp, TV screen, and car headlight we use today exists because of that discovery. Energy use dropped by 80%. Heat nearly disappeared. Lifespans multiplied. The blue LED wasn't just a breakthrough, it was one of humanity's brightest energy revolutions. For his work, Nakamura received the 2014 Nobel Prize in Physics. But the heart of this story isn't the award, it's the inspiration. Sometimes changing the world doesn't require a giant laboratory, just persistence, curiosity, and the courage to ask, why not? The blue LED is more than just a light, it's a symbol of science making the impossible possible. Today, our screens, our streets, and our cities all shine with the light of the blue LED. And that light reminds us of something simple. A small idea, in the right hands, can brighten the world.